Deer Creek Audio, your trusted technical resource.
Are you looking to build a compact home theater? In this video, we discuss a TV-centric design using miniDSP Flex with device console to create a dynamic 3.1 stereo system that adds depth and realism to the home movie experience. With the development of advanced performance in compact speakers and subwoofers, high-impact, high-fidelity sound is now attainable in a much smaller space. The concept is TV-centric, with sources connected to your TV by Wi-Fi, LAN, or HDMI. These sources can include Apple TV, a Blu-ray disc player, cable modem, Xbox, and others. The TV then routes digital PCM audio via the Toslink fiber optic to your Flex preamplifier. The Flex serves as the system's processor, incorporating the main left, main right, center channel, and subwoofer. The system features a simple TV-centric user interface, giving the user control over audio inputs. The Flex handles speaker signal routing, levels, and crossovers. This approach does not use an audio-video receiver or support Dolby or DTS decoding. From the TV, high-definition audio is output in PCM digital audio over Toslink fiber optic into the Flex. This provides a pure digital stereo signal that is then processed into the 3.1 channels. Set up your system as shown, and be sure to verify your connections as follows. Toslink from TV to Flex. RCA cable from Flex to subwoofer. RCA cables from Flex to 3-channel amplifier. Speaker wire connections from 3-channel amplifier to left, right, and center speakers. After all the physical connections are made, you'll use device console, the Flex user interface, to provide control access to the routing matrix, crossover frequencies, channel levels, and parametric equalization. This routing matrix shows how the center channel and subwoofer channel have been monorealized. By combining the left and right channels into one, the resulting monorealized channel creates a simple home theater listening environment. The channel gain is used to adjust the left, right, center, and subwoofer loudness to give the most balanced listening experience. It is possible to set up 4 different preset configurations, so you can have dedicated presets for movie night and high-definition audio listening. For signal routing, set the routing matrix on the input page of device console as follows. Output channels 1 and 2 for the stereo left and right. Channel 3 for the monorealized center channel. Channel 4 for the monorealized subwoofer. The crossovers between the main and center speakers and subwoofer follow typical audio-video standards. Here, we see the crossover setup page in device console, where the center channel speaker has a frequency range chosen primarily for voice. These crossovers will work well as shown, but also allow for user experimentation. In addition to the center channel tuned to enhance voice, here, you can see the crossover at 80 Hz is separating the subwoofer from the left and right main full-range speakers. You can verify polarities using REW and the invert feature on device console. This example shows inverting the subwoofer, which reveals a significant dip around the crossover frequency. The same thing can be done with the main and center speakers to determine if they are subtracting or adding to one another. The polarity is correct when the channel levels are additive. The next step is to set the speaker and subwoofer level using REW and a miniDSP UMIK. From the central listening area, adjust the levels to be close. More importantly, find the levels that provide the most enjoyable listening experience for you. In this example, we show a 3.1 setup with emphasis on the subwoofer and center channel levels. The most effective way to do this is to make adjustments for the best listening experience. Then verify what you're hearing with REW measurements. There are several options when it comes to tuning your system with room correction. Dirac Live provides state-of-the-art frequency and time domain room correction. You can tune to taste using the parametric equalizer in the miniDSP Flex. Or you can create equalization correction filters using REW. Before you begin your system and room correction project, complete all of the basic setup steps in the above sections. Then, do some serious listening to make sure you're pleased with the preliminary results. it's key to have a proper sounding system as a basis for a successful room correction project. This is a brief outline of the Dirac Live process. You can find the full user manual in the resources section of our website. First, create a Dirac Live account and download Dirac. Second, verify you have all the proper USB connections in place, with adequate room to see your computer and be able to fully move the microphone around the measuring area. Next, initiate Dirac Live from the miniDSP device console and confirm that you are logged in to your Dirac Live account. Perform Dirac Live level calibration. Next, select the focus listening area size and perform all specified measurements. Proceed to Dirac Live correction waveform creation. Then, export the Dirac Live project to any miniDSP preset and save your Dirac Live project. You can tune to taste by adding PEQ curves. These are applied on the device console output parametric equalization page and are created individually for each output channel, left, right, center, and subwoofer. In this example, we show a classic loudness curve that was generated using the Flex parametric equalizer. Once the system is set up, it is simple for the entire family to use. Modern televisions are equipped to accept a variety of high-performance digital video and audio sources that are easily selected from the TV's remote. You can simply use the remote to select the input desired. The system volume can be controlled by either the TV or the miniDSP Flex. Be sure to visit us at deercreekaudio.com for more resources, tech blogs, and product details. Keep watching our YouTube channel for more video releases.